Hello everyone, good morning, welcome to my channel. Hare Krishna, mechanical engineer. So we shall move forward for the next set of learnings. As we have already seen, what are the important aspects that I would be covering today, we would be taking the first topic, that is geometric dimensioning and tolerancing, and we would be focusing upon what is GD&T and why it has been widely used. So as the geometric dimensioning and tolerancing says, it is an international drawing language that communicates the functional requirements or the design intent of a component or assembly of components. So we would be having a question, what was there before GD&T? In this GD&T, initially before GD&T was being used, what are the different things that people used to consider? They used to refer coordinate drawing, and it has been used almost until 1994. After ASME, that is American Society of Mechanical Engineers, have designed the GD&T, we would be initially understanding what are the major advantages of GD&T. So here we can see the left side drawing, that is the coordinate drawing, and the dimensions are being dimensioned in this fashion, means the center is located through an upper limit and lower limit of the dimensional value, means the center can deviate from the left hand side from 9 any unit, it could be mm or inch, 9 mm to 11 mm, whereas the vertical also can deviate from 9 mm to 11 mm. What do we infer from this? We would be inferring the center can be adjusted in a fashion where the center can deviate leftward, rightward, upward and downward by 1 mm each. So it is a square tolerance. Here we can see this can deviate in the vertical dimension by 2 mm, that is one above and one bottom and one left and one right. Also we would understand what would be defining in GD&T. In GD&T we would be dimensioning with datum planes and the center with a position tolerance zone. So the dimensions to locate the center are being defined in a square block, that is basic dimensions. So we understand that basic dimensions do not possess any tolerance value, and the tolerance is all the way given only to the center, how much it can shift. The diametrical symbol means it can deviate diametrically, circularly, over a diameter of 2, referencing the datum A and datum B, that is been shown here. So datum A and datum B, this is datum A being in the left compartment, shows it is the primary datum, and anything after datum A would be secondary, tertiary, etc. What is the basic advantage that we possess using geometric dimensioning and tolerancing. If we see the overlap of the tolerance zone between the coordinate versus GD&T, we have a uniformity in the tolerance zone when measured from the center. Being centrally located from the leftward can be moved by 1 and the topward 1 mm. So when we see the diagonal movement, it is slightly greater than 1 in terms of numerical value. So the circular tolerance zone is being uniform from the center in all directions, whereas the square tolerance is slightly different when we move forward, when we move from the top center to the right corner or the right corner to the bottom corner, etc. So how that it affect us? If we consider, we move on. If we consider the pin center point as the blue point and the pin diameter that is here as diameter 8 and the tolerance zone in the green. When the pin moves within the tolerance zone in a circular fashion, it would be ensuring the pin would definitely fit on the mating hole of diameter 10. But if we slightly accept this tolerance zone, then the functional requirement is not being satisfied. That is, we are giving dimensioning in a square tolerance zone, but when the pin is being inserted in the hole, that may or may not match. This issue would be addressed using GD&T. So this is another image. As we finally conclude, why do we use GD&T? References to plus or minus dimensions have a limited way of controlling variation. The limits of minimum and maximum size have to control the form, orientation, and location of the feature. This can give rise to many issues such as conflicting requirements between position and flatness, tighter tolerances than what is necessary or required, ambiguity of the specification limits, or failure to effectively capture the design intent. So with this, in this video we would be concluding about why we would go for GD&T over coordinate dimensioning. And in the next videos, I shall take you through the actual GD&T usage, procedure, and applications. Thank you for spending your time in my channel. I wish you all the success. Please do not forget to like, comment, or subscribe. Thank you.